It's kind of weird, but sometimes I notice these paradigm shifts in Sega homebrew. And just of recent, I've noticed a shift from 2D to 3D. So for this video, I thought I'd cover a number of engines over a number of consoles, starting with the Sega Genesis and Mega Drive. This is an engine by Eric, which started out life using a lot of the SGDK library functions, but has since expanded and evolved and become its own thing. It has a lighting system that is very reminiscent of Doom, and there's a textured version that presently runs at a slower frame rate. If you're intrigued as I am about this project, click on the link in the top right hand corner to go and subscribe to Eric's channel. Next up we have an engine by Dave, which is loosely based on the SGDK, but has its own frame buffer. Dave also has an interest in FMV like me. Yeah, like you haven't seen those videos on my channel already. Be sure to check out Dave's channel by clicking the link in the top right hand corner. So this next thing isn't an engine, but it's a very interesting development. The SVP inside Virtual Racing has never really been explored in homebrew. Some devs believe Virtual Racing did not make full use of the SVP. Given the SVP is now available in FPGA, people have begun to wonder if a game could be written for it. But in order to do that, we need a better understanding of the chip itself. And that's where Javi Taiyu comes in. He's currently researching the SVP and documenting it. So fingers crossed in the future we might see something for this chip that isn't Virtual Racing. So now we move on to the Sega CD. What do you mean Sega CD? Isn't this a game you've covered previously that was a Mega Drive game? Well yeah, but the dev behind this game is an innovator and he's currently experimenting with the Sega CD's sub-CPU to see if he can create an accelerated version of his engine. So as I've said previously, this is definitely one to keep an eye on. So with this whistle-stop tour coming to an end, we'll now look at the 32X. First up, a port of Doom. Yep, I'm totally aware that a release of Doom was already on the system, but this is a port by Victor Luchitz, and it's based on the original Jaguar source code and ColecoDoom. I've been helping out with this port. Well, with testing, definitely no code on my part. It's to my knowledge the first game on the system to make use of the 32X's second SH2 CPU for rendering. Which to me is quite a big deal because it shows that it is possible to use both CPUs on the system. I do think this port has a lot of potential. The problem is it needs SH2 assembler programmers, and they seem to be pretty rare. If you think you could help with the project, be sure to look up Victor on Twitter. And last but not least, I wanted to quickly show this demo by Mars Sample Program on Twitter. It shows the 32X doing some 3D rendering and also has an audio driver, which I think is called Gemma, which takes advantage of the PWM audio channels on the 32X. Thank you for stopping by and watching this video to the end. If you know of any interesting devs that I've missed or have something you'd like to say, please do so in the comments below. Click the like or dislike button and I'll see you in the next video. Well, unless you click the dislike button, that is. Come on.